I'm excited, I'm elated to be here. Good evening to you all. I have been a Toastmaster for the last 5 years. And the first time I joined Toastmaster, in that first year, I was so excited. I was as busy as a bee because I had wanted to join Toastmasters for such a long time. But at the time, I worked in Murang'a, a town out of Kenya. And 5 years ago, there were no Toastmasters clubs out of Nairobi. I took part in everything I could in that first year. But after the first year, ladies and gentlemen, I got a new job. And what that meant is that I began to dedicate more time to my work and less to Toastmasters. It was with shock and dismay that this year I realized that the legacy program of Toastmasters was coming to an end, and I had barely completed my competent communicator manual, which is a path you take in the legacy program. This is the spark that caused me to reconnect back to Toastmasters and reconnect fully mind, body, and soul. As I was taking part in the speeches, evaluating my fellow Toastmasters, and generally being a good Toastmaster, my then Vice President Education and good friend, her name is Sarah, asked me to consider joining the Table Topics contest. At the time, I didn't think much of it. In fact, I gave her a quick yes, of course I will. I didn't think much of it after that. And only 1 week to the club contest, did I wake up with shock that I had not rehearsed and I was not sure what was expected of me. I thought that I was going to be a complete charlatan in front of people. And some of the thoughts I had in my mind is, one, I will be asked a question and I will have nothing to say. Or worse yet, I will be asked a question and say the most stupid thing you can imagine, embarrassing myself to eternity. That said, I asked for the help of a lot of mentors in that time period, and I received tremendous support from my club, from the club contest, and I'm happy to report that I was able to get all the way to the district contest, one of my proud achievements. Tonight, I want to share with you all things that have helped me along the way, in particular, three things. I fondly call them the two P's and an S. Let's start with the lone S. The lone S is structure. This accounts for a third of all the contest marks you will receive during the Table Topics contest. And it means that you need to have a defined structure when you speak. There are so many to pick from the chronological order to even the four wives and one husband. What do I mean? What, where, when, why, and how? I found myself, as I was practicing, gravitating towards one particular structure. That is, every time I was asked a question during Table Topics, and particularly during the contest, I would answer what my reason is for that answer, and I would give two whys why I picked that answer. Let me demonstrate. I was once asked during the contest, Purity, is it better to have loved and lost or never to have loved at all? My immediate answer was, it is better to have loved and lost because, one, having loved, I have enjoyed the benefits of being loved. But two, it is better to have loved and lost because I gained great relationship tips along the way. And then usually I will end with a call to action such as, love is one of the greatest virtues on earth, and love is a choice. Who are you choosing to love today? And I would end my Table Topic session there. This has served me well in the time period I've had to compete in the Table Topics contest, and I found it to be tremendously helpful even during the club Table Topics session. Pick a structure that you enjoy, a structure that comes easily to you, and use it. The second tip that I'd like to share with you this evening is the first P, which is practice. Practice will make you better, and it certainly made a big difference for me. I asked my fellow clubmates to practice with me, particularly those who were taking part in the Table Topics contest, and we practiced 3 times every week until the district contest, at least for me, because that is where I reached in my contest. I even know of fellow contestants who asked their clubs to slot them in for every Table Topic session in their club to allow them to practice. What I found when I practiced is that when the contest came around, some of the answers that I had been practicing during my rehearsals somehow could fit with some of the questions I was asked during the contest, and I was able to use them. Pick a structure that you like. Practice, practice, practice. You cannot do without it. The last P is positive. Did you know, Toastmasters and guests, that our brain thinks so much faster than we are able to speak? And out of nervousness, when you're asked a question impromptu, your brain automatically gives you multiple answers, multiple solutions. And in nervousness, you can easily put all your answers, jumble them, try to make sense of them. And I ran out of time a number of times. My mentors told me that this was one of my biggest challenges. Pausing at the beginning of the Table Topics question, or even during the Table Topics answer, even as you deliver it, will do you great service, because it will allow you to decide one answer that you want to stick with. And from there, trust your gut that you have made the right choice and take it to the very end. Life gives us multiple opportunities, but life does not give us notice before the opportunity comes. A great man once said that opportunities multiply the more they are seized. And so whether you take part in the Table Topics contest or you want to just sharpen your impromptu skills, these impromptu skills will be valuable and will allow you to seize every opportunity so that you can stand head and shoulder above your fellow mates in the world. Consider the 2 P's and an S to allow you to stand out. Structure, practice, and pauses. Taking part in the Table Topics contest, ladies and gentlemen, has been so valuable to me. First, I used to only be called Purity Mithika Customer Experience Professional, but today I am called Purity Mithika Customer Experience Professional and Table Topics Champion. The second value that I have gained from taking part in the Table Topics contest is that I have gained myriad friends, from my mentors to the contestants to those that I practiced with religiously 3 times a week, to the many people I have met as I have been asked to share my story, as I am doing with you today. I have gained numerous friends, but finally, saying yes to the Table Topics contest reinforced my trust and belief in myself, that I have potential, that I can achieve so much more than I thought I could. It has emboldened my ego. Say yes to the Table Topics contest. Say yes to practicing your impromptu skills and get ready for every benefit that you will accrue from that.